Hey guys, it's Embers here, and today I show you the ultimate freeze strategy. It's Ninja Ice Sniper. So the gameplay, of course it's ultra late game. I speed the gameplay up to over 300%, so you don't have to wait hours to see the late game. And yes, I want to show not only one game, cause yeah, sometimes it's a good or a bad game. So I recorded two games and they are over an hour long. So yeah, that's why I went for the 300%, over 300% speed up. So yeah, the first thing I want to say is I'm sorry that I don't upload at the moment, rarely. It's yeah, I have not that much time, and yeah, so that's the part I don't like, but I can't change anything about this strategy. You can use the strategy mostly, or I think in the best case, on Bonanza mode, cause yeah, you maybe have some problems to defend round 13 all out, and with Bonanza money you can upgrade tons of ninjas or snipers in the background and just defend any rush. So it's possible to go on normal games with the strategy, but take care the early rounds, cause you are really weak, you don't have that good grouped camo popping power, cause if your enemy sends you a ton camo rig roulette rush, you could maybe die. So yeah, it's possible, but yeah, you have to take care. So how I play the strategy? Well, early on, exactly, especially in Bonanza, you go for massive income. The first game I went for super eco boost, which doesn't matter, but I also want to get some experience for eco. And the second part is damage boost. If you want the ultimate freezy strategy for the late game, I went in the second game. I don't know how the power is called. It's where the Moabs or Moab balloon types are just get slowed on top with the ninja and ice low. So it's the ultimate freeze strategy. And if you want to be safe, you can go for the damage boost part. So yeah, that's the difference. But normally, if you have good defense, the enemy don't want to rush you early on, cause yeah, both go for late game on Bonanza mode the most time, and that's why, yeah. And my enemy has a Super Monkey Ice Sniper Wizard strategy. Well, it's a good strategy, cause he is safe for the early game with the wizard, and has also double stall with the ice and sniper. And of course Super Monkey is the best late game tower. But what is if we all out him with millions of Somai Guts, which is impossible to defend? And if he tries to counter rush you, you just stall the hell out of the rounds. So let's say you slow the Somai Gut with the ninja 50%, then on top with the ice 50% again, so the Somai Guts only have a speed with 25%, and on top, and here's the fun fact, you put your snipers, as I did in the game, overall in the track, close to the track, and put the sniper with 4-2 on close. So they always attack the Zomagot, which is close to the sniper. And on top you put one sniper on strong with 4-2 and one sniper on strong with 4-0. So this last two snipers only attack the first Zomagot, but with some different speeds, so they don't shoot at the same time, and the first Zomagot is even more stalled. And yeah, that's the secret about the strategy. And as you can see, my Morabs are looks like they stopped or stopping by, and now also the BFBs. And yeah, that's I think a sneaky tricky strategy. And you don't need to upgrade tons of defense. You can just put your defense as much up as you need to defend the AI rounds. And if your enemy starts to all out you, like round 40, 45, 50, 60, doesn't matter, just counter rush him. And yeah, of course, with the ultimate tree strategy, you don't need to destroy the Zomagot, you just need to wait till he dies. So yeah, I think in this scenario, it's sneaky strategy, it's a fun strategy. And yes, of course, you have to go ultra late game. And one more fact for the strategy: the longer the map is, the better the strategy is. It's of course understandable if the Zomagot needs normally 30 seconds to go all around, the free strategy let him need from 30 seconds around about 120 seconds only with the ninja and ice, and on top with the sniper slow or stun, I don't know the numbers, but let's say 200 seconds. And on the enemy part, he needs the DPS for 30 seconds to destroy the Zomagot. And yeah, so that's the hidden strategy, or the power of the strategy. And every time you go for a slow strategy, let's say any ninja strategy, you have more powerful advantage the longer the map is. So round 50, I decided to all out him. And of course, with Bonanza mode, yeah, it's over millions I sent him. So, and you see my side, it's speed over 300%. My Zomagots, BFBs, Moabs close to stay on the place. And yeah, on his side, the ZMGs just rush through his map. And even with the Super Monkeys, he don't have the DPS to destroy. And yeah, that's an easy peasy win for me. So yeah, on the second map, he went for the Super Monkey, as you saw in the intro. He went for an Haley gameplay, but it doesn't matter. The ultimate free strategy is, yeah, it's pretty OP. And here, like I said before, I don't know the name of the power, I'm sorry. It's just for the extra slow of the mob type balloons. And with this strategy, you can just even stall the ZMGs just more and yeah, go for the easy win. And again, you have to be safe if your enemy rushes you, because as you can see, if he would all out me now, I would need tons of money to defend. So yeah, I decided to go for a ninja or a 2-4 ninja close to the ice tower. And round 50, he should normally send me camo weak roulettes. So yeah, to pressure me or maybe go for the win. but normally if you have lightning bolts and if you want to go for the safe strategy, or you can just put damage boost on top, and you should be probably safe. But on the other side, you don't want to waste your powers like damage boost in the early game when you try to win the late game. But it's only safe parts of the powers. You do not really need any powers, because you don't want, well, you don't need to destroy the Oh My God all out in the late game, because you just chill, lean back and wait till your enemies die. And normally you can just wait till he starts to rush you and just counter rush him. So yeah, that's a fun strategy, or yeah, let's say it's like Bonanza if you want to have some non-try hard games and chill and don't sweat that much. And yeah, that's sometimes it's a good part, and I want to upload something else and not only the boss strategies or the boss maps or BFBs. So yeah, sometimes it makes just more fun to play some different types. And yeah, tell me, what do you think about the strategy? Maybe you tried the strategy on yourself out and have some opinions here. So on round 28, I started to place my snipers, as you can see. And yeah, the more snipers you place close to each other, the stronger the stun is. And on the right bottom corner, I put down my 4-2 and 4-0 sniper on strong, and all the other snipers are on close with 4-2 upgrades. So here I didn't check the map. Round 32 is a pretty strong AI round, and I was close to die. But yeah, finally I just defend the round closely. And yeah, from here the next part is just go for the ice towers, and swamp with ice towers is just godly tower, cause every time a mob pops into normal balloons, the ice shards just hits tons of damage. And on the background, I upgraded some to 4 ninjas just for the safety. Normally you just need 4 ninjas with the slow, but yeah, I have no problems. I have the money to go just for 5, 6, 7 ninjas, so you don't need to calculate the time exactly, and can just slow every 10 seconds and you are safe. And here you can see I don't pop the BFBs faster than my enemy does with the Hades, but they are closely on one position, and every time the more pops and the normal balloons came out, the ice shards to the job. So yeah, it's not the strongest defense, and I didn't place tons of ninjas to have the DPS, but it works all in all pretty fine. And yeah, why should I go for an upgrade? So here I just spammed my lightnings to just drop them out, but I normally shouldn't. Oh, I didn't need it. And yeah, round 42, it looks like my defense is crap, because I just even cannot defend the mobs. So I had to upgrade some more defense to be able to defend the AI balloons. And yeah, I realized, okay, I have to upgrade. I was way too greedy, and so I used my mob slow power. And here he don't even have the Oh My God, just only Hades. I just thought, okay, he cannot defend an all out, and I went for the all out. And on my side, as you can see, my Oh My God are closely to stay. And yeah, that's GG. I hope you enjoyed. Drop me some comments, and I catch you on the next one. Bye bye.